Hello friends, welcome to A2S Learning. In this video, we'll study about the cell, its structure and function. A cell is defined as the structural and functional unit of living organism. All living organisms are made up of cells. Cells are found in different shapes and sizes. Ostrich egg is the largest cell and nerve cell is the longest cell. Classification of cell. Based on the presence of nucleus, cells are classified into two types, prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cell. Prokaryotes are unicellular organisms, for example bacteria, whereas eukaryotes can either be unicellular, for example amoeba, or multicellular organisms, for example plants and animals. Prokaryotic cells does not have a membrane-bound nucleus. As seen in bacteria, the DNA here is bundled together in nucleoid region, but it is not stored within a membrane-bound nucleus. Whereas eukaryotic cells such as plants and animals have a membrane-bound nucleus. Structure of an eukaryotic cell. The cell can be divided basically into two main parts, cell membrane and protoplasm. Protoplasm has two distinctions, the nucleus and cytoplasm. The cell membrane. The cell membrane, also called plasma membrane, is a very thin elastic membrane that forms the boundary of the cell. It has fine pores which allow only a few substances to enter and leave the cell. Therefore, it is called semi-permeable membrane. Cell membrane gives mechanical support to animal cells. It controls passage of materials into and out of the cell. The cell wall. In addition to cell membrane, plant cells have a non-living deposition outside their plasma membrane called cell wall. It is usually composed of cellulose. Cell wall gives shape and rigidity to the cells. Protoplasm. Cytoplasm and nucleus together form the protoplasm. Nucleus. It is a dense spherical living body located near the center of the cell in animal cells, and it is located towards the periphery in plant cells. All the cells contain nucleus except human red blood cells, which does not have nucleus. Nucleus consists of the fluid called nucleoplasm, which is enclosed by nuclear membrane. Each nucleus contains nucleolus, which are associated with chromosomes. Nucleus also contains chromatin fibers, which are long thread-like strands. At the time of cell division, they become distinct and short structures called chromosomes. A chromosome is a long DNA molecule with part of all the genetic material of an organism. Nucleus controls all the activities of the cell, including the cell division. Cytoplasm. Cytoplasm is located between the cell membrane and the nuclear membrane of the cell. The cytoplasm consists of two main components, cytosol and organelles. Cytosol is a jelly-like mixture that consists mostly of water, along with proteins, carbohydrates, salts, minerals, and organic molecules. Organelles are living part of the cell. Each organelle carries out its own function. The following are the cell organelles: endoplasmic reticulum, ribosomes, Golgi apparatus, lysosomes, mitochondria, centrosomes, plastids, and vacuoles. So now let us study the function of these organelles. Endoplasmic reticulum. It is a network of tubes which may or may not connect the plasma membrane with the nuclear membrane. There are two types of endoplasmic reticulum: smooth endoplasmic reticulum and rough endoplasmic reticulum. Rough endoplasmic reticulum is studded with small structures called ribosomes, whereas smooth endoplasmic reticulum does not contain ribosomes. Endoplasmic reticulum provides mechanical support to cytoplasm and transports substances within the cell. Ribosomes. These are minute spherical granules attached to the endoplasmic reticulum. They are formed in the nucleus but mostly found in cytoplasm attached to endoplasmic reticulum. Ribosomes play major role in the synthesis of proteins. They are sites for protein synthesis. Golgi apparatus. It is made up of flattened sac-like structures called cisternae. It is usually found near nucleus. Proteins which are formed in endoplasmic reticulum are processed in Golgi apparatus. Golgi apparatus stores proteins and enzymes. Lysosomes. These are sac-like structures containing digestive enzymes. Lysosomes destroy any foreign particles which enter the cell. They even digest the damaged cell. That is why they are called suicidal bags of the cell. Mitochondria. Mitochondria are relatively large organelles of varying shapes distributed uniformly in the cytoplasm. Mitochondria are sites of ATP synthesis. They are responsible for extracting energy from the food during cellular respiration. Hence, they are called the powerhouse of the cell. Centrosome. It is found near the nucleus in the cytoplasm of animal cells. Centrosome initiates animal cell division. Plastids. They are living double-walled structures and occur only in plant cells. There are three types of plastids: chloroplast, chromoplast, and leucoplast. Chloroplast. They are green in color and contain a green pigment called chlorophyll. The chlorophyll present in chloroplast traps solar energy and helps in photosynthesis. Chromoplast. They are non-green and do not possess chlorophyll. They impart beautiful colors to flowers to attract insects for pollination. Leucoplast. They are colorless plastids. Leucoplasts are involved in the storage of food materials like starch in the plant cell. Vacuoles. Vacuoles are non-living fluid-filled spaces enclosed by a membrane called tonoplast. Generally, they are found in plant cells. If present in animal cells, they are very small and temporary. Vacuoles stores water, minerals, food in the form of simple sugar and waste products. To summarize, these are the organelles which are found both in plant and animal cells. Cell membrane, nucleus, endoplasmic reticulum, mitochondria, Golgi apparatus, and lysosomes. So now let's differentiate the plant cell and animal cell. Cell wall is present in plant cell, whereas cell wall is absent in animal cell. Chloroplast is present in plant cell, chloroplast is absent in animal cell. Centrosome is absent in plant cell, whereas centrosome is present in animal cell. Vacuoles are large and permanent in plant cell. Usually, vacuoles are absent in animal cell, and if present, they are small and temporary. So that's basically for this video. Thank you for watching. For more videos, please do like and subscribe to my channel.